So Ms. Mara, what I'm going to do is, because there's three different faces to it, I'm going to log in with a grade 2 kid first to show that way, then with a grade 3 to 5 students platform, and then with a middle school platform.
Okay. أول إشي رح نعمل login لما في عنا ثلاث مراحل للlogin عنا login لgrade 2 و 3 وبعدها and the other grade what?
So grade 2, then grade 3 to 5 and then grade 6, 7, 8.
أوكي عنا مرحلتين للlogin عنا مرحلة الأولى هي للصف الثاني وعنا من الصف الثالث للخامس في من السادس للسابع للثامن.
Okay, this is the account number for all students. So this is very important that they have this account number.
Okay, this is the account number for all the kids, for all the levels.
Yeah.
هذا الأكاونت نمبر عند كل الطلاب من صف ثاني لصف ثامن هو نفس الرقم.
Okay. So this is the grade 2 platform and this is how it looks when you log in. Okay, so once you log in, you have, okay, one second. I'm just, there's people coming into the waiting room. Okay, once you log in, you have your home page, okay? Down on the left-hand side, you've got all the different tasks and pages you can go to, okay? Currently, I can see this student has 4 new assignments. To see any new assignments, you just click. Is that okay, Mara?
Yes, can you back a little bit? Go back.
Okay, so this is your home page.
Okay. بمجرد ما تعمل الأكاونت، تعمل تسجيل دخول، هاي الصفحة الرئيسية اللي حتطلع لك على الأكاونت. في عندك هون على جهة اليسار عندك كل الأسايمنت. وعندك بالنص عندك هون في البوكس الأزرق عندك 4 أسايمنت.
So yeah. Yes. Click into your assignments. Now you can see all the different assignments that have been set by that teacher, when they are due and what they are for. So this one, it has a calculator, so that's maths. This one has a little pencil, so it's English.
Okay, بمجرد ما تضغط على الـ four assignment حيطلع لك ايش عنده الassignment اللي لازم يعملها خلال الاسبوع هذا. عندك اول واحد اللي هو على شكل آلة حاسبة رياضيات بعدين عندك math ونفس الاشي. كل محدد لك متى آخر يوم تسليم. آخر يوم تسليم اللي هو يوم الجمعة. Yes.
Okay, you click into the activity and now you've got 3 different activities. Depending on what the topic is, you might only have 2 or you could have 3. It usually is a lesson, then some practice and then a little quiz.
بمجرد ما تضغط على أول assignment حيطلع لك ثلاث مهمات. هذا ممكن تكون 3 ممكن تكون 2 أو 1 هذا بيعتمد على المادة اللي معمولها أصلا.
Okay. You click into it and then it opens up the lesson like so. Sorry, it's taking a second. So then, obviously, as it's for these younger kids, it is very interactive, it's got music, it's got games, and so on. You start on your assignment.
There are 2 A's.
And there's videos, there's often loads of interactive pieces of information for the kids to work with.
بمجرد ما تضغط على الاسايمنت انت اخترته وتضغط بلاي حيطلع لك فيديو حيطلع لك اغنيه حيطلع لك اي شيء ريليتد للاسايمنت.
Okay. Down here then is the quiz. The quiz usually has 4 to 5 questions in it. And it relates directly to everything that was done in the assignment, in the lesson.
في نهاية بعد ما تخلص الأسايمنت الأول والثاني في نهاية الخيارات عندك كويز، الكويز بيكون من 4 لـ 5 أسئلة، كل الأسئلة بتعود على الأسايمنت اللي كانت موجودة فوق.
Okay. Just to go through. So exactly what was in the quiz, you can play it with your speaker, and it reads out what the question is for the students, and then they can just simply input their answers and then submit. And you move throughout the whole question or the whole quiz, and then at the end, it will give you a percentage. For you to move on or to pass this assignment, you need to get 4 out of 5 questions right. If you only get less than 4, you have to retake the lesson again. So you would have to go back and retake the lesson. So just wait for this to load. So for example, here, this is only locked because I've only got 20%. I now have to retake the lesson again.
اوكي بمجرد ما تنتهي من الاسسمنت في عندك تحت كويز. الكويز بيكون من 4 لـ5 اسئله ويجب الجواب على اقل شيء 4 اسئله من اصل 5. لو جاوبت اخذت اقل من 4 برجع بعمل لك بلوك، لازم ترجع مره ثانيه تحل الاسسمنت من اول وجديد عشان تحصل على علامه 4 أو 5. في عندك ميزه ثانيه لما تفتح على السؤال في الكويز بيقرا لك السؤال وبيقرا لك الجواب.
Okay, so then yes, I can see all of my assignments. I can see this now that I've started it, and I can go back and continue it. So you can see exactly where you are in your week's work.
بمجرد ما ترجع الصفحة الرئيسية بيطلع لك أنت وأي مادة وصلت، خلصتها كامل، ضايل جزء بسيط فيها، تقدر ترجع تعمل continue وترجع تكمل الأسس.
So they're all your teacher assignments. The other aspect to this is your learning path. This is where the kids can individually work on their own. So your learning path is built to be at your level, so at the student's level. And you've got a math one and an English one. And there's got a lesson, practice, and quiz. So the exact same setup. The students can work on these individually in their own time.
Okay. عندنا على اليسار عندنا learning path. The learning path هذا بتكون للطالب نفسه بحيث يقدر يدرب نفسه في الماث والانجلش. بمجرد ما تضغط على learning path حيطلع لك الشاشة هذه، حيطلع لك فيها درس lesson والpractice والquiz.
Is everything okay, Anna? Have you a question? I see your hand is up.
Hi, I was just writing in the chat part actually. It was just that my main problem is that I actually can't get into the system. So I've used the password and the, I've used all the information that came, I don't know if they're called usernames or passwords or whatever, but I just actually can't get into it. So that's the support I suppose I need before I can get on with it.
Okay, I'm gonna send you, what's the name of your child?
It's Matilda Crampen.
What class, what grade is she in?
She's in year 1.
Okay, give me 1 second and I should be able to get.
What we'll do is, we will afterwards, IT will personally contact you to kind of troubleshoot exactly what's going on with Matilda, but thanks for the feedback.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We can get the details sent out just to make sure, because it is very sensitive to the passwords. So if there's capitals, it needs to be capitals and so on. Okay, has anyone else got any questions on the lower grades platform?
في أي سؤال عن exact path للطلاب المرحلة الصف الثاني؟ مين عنده أي سؤال؟
Two hands, yes. No. Okay. So what I'm going to do is also show you this last thing down here is the rewards. So in here, when you complete activities, so this student last year, you can see the different rewards that she has earned. So she got a math skill perfected, math skill mastered. So you get rewards for completing different different activities and badges and things like that. So when the kids do challenges, they get all these different badges. So depending on what activities have been set, this more for this year, the student hasn't got any, but you can see that English and maths are there, badges and rewards they can earn.
Okay. نفس الشيء على جهة learning path على اليسار تحت في خانة الجوائز تنحط للطلاب اللي بيكملوا كل نشاط بيعملوه كامل وبياخذوا full marks بياخذوا جائزة في عنا للإنجليش والماث.
Okay, I'm now going to log into the grade 3 to 5 platform so you can see how it's that little bit different, and then I'll go into the grade 6, 7, and 8. So again, this passcode is always the same for every student.
عنا الكود هو نفسه للطلاب من صف ثاني لصف ثامن نفسه هو الكود ما بيختلف. الحين حنعمل لوجن على من صف ثالث للصف الخامس عشان نشوف كيف هي مختلفة عن الصف الثاني.
Okay, so this is a grade 3 to 5 platform. And as you can see, it's a little bit more adult. It's not as playful as the younger versions one. And it's a very similar layout. So you've got your assignments here, so we can see exactly what assignments are due. This one is due next Thursday. So 2 assignments there. And you can click on them to see which ones are actually available. So there we go. We can see completed ones, and then we can see the ones that are due next week. And it's the exact same layout as the younger ones, where you will have your tutorial, practice, and a quiz. And just like that, you have to get 80% and above to move on.
اوكي اول ما تدخل على تعمل ساين ان على الصفحه الرئيسيه من جريد 3 ل 5 نفس بتاعت جريد 2 بس فيها مور ديتيلز وفيها تفاصيل اكثر. عندك على اليسار عندك الاسسمنت تضغط على الاسسمنت بيطلع لك فيها نفس الاسسمنت بتاعت جريد 2. Could you, Mr. Martin, could you click on the assessment please?
This here?
No, the front page.
Yeah.
هون حيطلع لك على الاسسمنت اللي انت خلصتها عملتها completed وعندك الاسسمنت اللي الاسبوع هذا بتخلص لازم تعملها. نفس الشيء لما تضغط على الاسسمنت اللي هي due next week. Could you click on it?
Yep.
نفس الخيارات اللي موجوده عندك اول شيء اللسن بعدين الاسسمنت بعدين عندك الكويز. What should the total mark for the quiz?
So yeah, you have tutorial, practice, and then down the quiz, and you have to get 80% in the quiz again.
Okay, عندك أول إشي tutorial للassessment, بعدين عندك practice تدريبات وآخر إشي quiz. The quiz لازم تجيب 80% عشان تعدي quiz.
So if you receive less than 80% in the quiz, it will lock, and you have to retake the tutorial and practice. So the quiz will lock. And for you to progress, you have to get 80% and above.
إذا أخذت في الكويز less than 80 راح تعمل لك لوك على الكويز ولازم ترجع على التوتوريال والبراكتس.
Okay. And again, like the younger classes, we've got our learning path. And on our learning paths again, you have got your math, you've got English, and you've got your language arts. So you've got 3 different platforms here, and that's the icons at the top. So the calculator is math, the pencil is language arts, and then the book is reading.
عندنا نفس الشيء لgrade 2 learning path, بس learning path الحين عندنا اياها اللي هي math, والenglish, واللanguage, والart.
Yeah, and again, it's the exact same setup. You've got 3. You've got a lesson, You got practice and quiz. And up here at the top, it has this I for the information. What is this topic? Multiplying two-digit by two-digit numbers, and it tells you then where it fits into the topic. So numbers and operations. You have to complete all four of these and get 80% or above to unlock this progress check. So if you only get 60% in one of them, you have to retake the lesson for you to be able to get this progress check.
Okay. في learning path حكينا هي للطالب نفسه على أساس يطور مهاراته ويحسن من مهاراته. في عندك learning path حكيناهم هم الثلاثة math والenglish واللanguage والart. عندك علامة الاستفهام في أول خانة هي زي معلومات عن الدرس ومعلومات عن lesson اللي حيعمل عليه quiz. بحيث لازم نكمل أول شيء lesson والpartition بعدين the quiz. لو أخذ علامة أقل من 18 في الكويز بيعمل locked ولازم يرجع يعيد من الأول. لو أنجز الأربع مراحل هذه حيعمل unlock على البروجرس تبعت level.
Okay. One second. Okay. So then, like I said, you've got your English one, your reading, and your writing, your language arts. And it's the same setup in each one of them. You have to make sure you complete all the activities. Your home feed here is where you can see exactly what's going on. So I know I have two new assignments and I can see exactly when they're due. Again, like the younger group, you have this reward system. So this student here, you can see they did different ones. They got this brain one was for a challenge. They've got an LA skill perfected and they've got math skills mastered. And then you can see their progress throughout each of them. Currently the student hasn't worked on anything, so you cannot see any progress in these. But as these get completed, they turn green and you can see the progress that student is making.
لما تضغط على الهوم بيج راح يطلع لك الاسسمنت والاسسمنت اللي خلصته واللي ضايل عليه لازم يخلصه الاسبوع هذا. عندنا نفس الشيء في جريت وعندنا الريوردز هنا، الريوردز برضه للانجلش excuse me Martin reward for English and math and language art right?
Yeah.
الريوردز عندنا للانجلش والماث واللانجوج والارت. حتى تعرف مستوى تقدم الطالب من خلال ببين لك الجوائز اللي هو ماخذها.
This is just an example of a previous student where you can see where they've completed work. So last year, verbs 100% and so on. And then mastered here. You have to get above 80% to master it. And you can print the certificates in there too. So the students can see where they have done well. These ones then were challenges where they completed a mental math challenge and they spent 20 minutes on their learning path activities. So the two main areas are your learning path and your assignments.
Reward لازم لما حكيناها نفسها انه تشوف تقدم الطالب من خلال الجوائز اللي اخذها لازم يكون جايب اعلى من 80% حتى يكون ماستر
Phil. Now I'm going to show the older year group, so grade 6 to 8.
الحين راح نفتح على الإكزاكت باث للطلاب من صف السادس للثامن.
Okay, this is, again, as you go up through the year groups, the platform face looks different. This is your older grades from grade 6 to 8. On these, you can see this student now has got two activities that they need to complete. So you've got this float like a butterfly, multiply like a bee, and it tells you when it's due. So that the 1st of the 10th, 20. So it's due at the beginning of next week. Along with that, on this page, it shows you there are new challenges, okay? So students have been set challenges. In this one, it's been labeled as a test, and this one here is an English challenge. So you click on these to see what's the actual reward. It's a bit slow today. Okay, so we've got this in progress. This student hasn't earned any rewards yet as it's a new year, but you can check again where they're at, what they've been working on. So I can see nothing has been worked on yet in any of those areas. I go back to my home. My learning paths. The learning paths are the most important. Students always have a little bit of work to do on their learning paths. So this is independent work. Do you want us to go, Mara? Sorry.
Okay. كل ما طلعنا لمرحلة أعلى راح تلاقي الـ exact path الـ home page اتغيرت وصارت فيها more details. يعني عندنا هذه من grade 6 ل grade 8 غير عن grade 3 to 5 فيها more details. عندنا أول إشي أول ما تفتح الـ home page حيطلع لك الـ activity اللي عليها assessment لازم يخلصوها وتحت في التواريخ مثلا أول واحد التاريخ 10/1 الأسبوع الجاي لازم يكون مخلصه. على شقة اليمين عندك اللي هي new challenge التحديات الجديدة للطلاب في مثلا يكون عندنا للإنجليش لم could you do a click on the English new challenge
this okay
no in the right one
oh Not the chat one. Oh sorry
yeah
Very slow.
بعد ما تضغط على النيو تشالنج راح يطلع لك الجوائز كبدايه لسه باول سنه ممكن ما تلاقي اي جوائز لانه لسه في بدايه السنه بس ضلك شيء كل فتره وفتره حتلاقي انه كل ما يخلص اسسمنت حيطلع له جائزه اوكي
Okay, so you can see here, these are two new challenges that have been set. This is the math one, okay? And it was set by me and it's for 60 minutes. And I can see how long of the 60 minutes that student has completed. This one here is an English one. So Mr. Hamza set it up to spend 40 minutes on their English learning path. And that was set for the 21st of the 9th. So that was set for today. So by clicking on these, you can see what information, what is the challenge, what do you need to work on to get it completed.
Okay. بمجرد ما تضغط على new challenge حيطلع لك الأربع rewards على حسب المادة. يعني في عندنا هنا مستر حمزة حط للإنجليش لازم يقعد 40 دقيقة على on learning path activities وبين له كم المدة اللي قاعدها عشان يخلص هلا على الانجليش من ال 40 دقيقه في عنده كمان تايم متى اخر يوم تسليم يس
اوكي سو if I go back to my home screen on my home screen I will see any new assignments as well as my learning paths I will always see my learning paths on my home screen in middle school so grade 6 to 8 always have their learning paths So you've got two activities here, but if I keep scrolling down, I've got my, right here, my reading learning path, and I've got my math learning path. You can click into these and complete activities at any time on those. So kids can work on these independently at any time they want. If I keep scrolling down, I can now see that I have an overdue assignment. It's an assignment that I didn't complete on time and it's overdue. By clicking into it, you can still complete that activity. And again, it looks very similar to the younger grades in how it's set up. It will have a lesson, a practice, and a quiz.
اوكي بمجرد ما ترجع على الهوم بيج عندك learning path، learning path كثير مهمة على اساس تشوف مستوى تقدم الطالب في في المواد. مجرد تنزل تحت في الصفحة الرئيسية حيطلع لك learning path, reading, math, English. في لهم وقت محدد يكون مستلمين. هنا في عنا learning path تاعك الانجليش due يوم 9/17/9, يعني already اجى الوقت عليه وخلص, بس تقدر انت تدخل عليه وتحله. ليك ال learning path الاسسمنت بيقدر يعملها في اي وقت بس قبل المدة المحددة اللي قبل ما تنتهي.
If we go to our learning path, students often say they don't have work to complete. In your work, learning path, there is loads of work. There's always activities in here. You can see the progress of those activities. It will be blue if it started, green completed, and then yellow, not completed but not mastered. See these little pluses? You need to make sure you click on the plus to actually get into all the activities. So in this one here, there's over 8 different activities that you have to work at before you get on to the end of topic quiz, so your progress check. So there's always work to be done on Mastery Connect, or on ExactPath, sorry.
مو شرط لازم المدرس يحط assessment على ال exact path للطلاب عشان يعملوه. في عندهم ال learning path. learning path دائما فيها فيها أنشطة للطلاب بيعملوها. في عندك هنا all works, عندك العلامة الزرقاء اللي هي لسه ما عمل ال assessment, الأخضر completed, الأصفر ما حل ولا إشي. مجرد ما تضغط على أول زائد real numbers بيطلع لك اللي هي tutorial, وبعديها تحت نفس الاشي الاكسبلينيشن مور للتوتوريال, بعدين تحت بيكون عندك ال could you go down a little bit.
اوكي يا
بعدين في اخر اشي, في اخر اشي حيطلع لك اللي هو البروجرس تشيك.
Perfect. And that's it, the exact same for maths, English, and science, or maths, English, and reading. So you always have those quizzes and the progress checks every kind of 4 topics. It's to make sure that everything keeps getting updated. With this as well, your learning path is at your level. So we do the kids, they do their math testing, and then when they finish their math testing, their paths get generated to the level they are at. So the work is at the level that they are currently working at. So I'll just click into the English one. And again, it will look very similar. Okay, so again, you've got all these 4 different topics in it. Some tasks have 3, some of them have 2. And again, right at the bottom, you have got this reading progress check.
Okay, في learning path عنا كتير مهم اللي هو الإنجليش والماث والreading. هذول كتير مهمين حتى level تبع الطلاب يتحسن ويضل المدرس عارف level طلابه وين. فإذا ما عنده assessment محطوط على ال exact path, في عنده دائما learning path عنده assessment يعمله.
Okay, the last place to check is all my work. If you click into all my work, you will see all the assignments that you have ever been given. And they will all be on this page. So you can scroll down and see all the different assignments. So these are assignments that were going back last year. So there's language arts ones, there's math ones, there's reading. You can see all the different assignments. You can then click in to see which ones you've actually done. So see this one here. It has been completed by that student. They've got 100%, and you can see the activities that they have completed in that. You can go into in progress to see which ones are in progress. There is always going to be work in here because all 3, math, reading, and language arts, are always in progress. You can check your completed ones to see which ones you've done. So you've done your reading diagnostic, math diagnostic, and completed one activity. So you can check every single assignment, and then not started. I can currently see this student has not started these 3 assignments. Okay, and if they're overdue, they need to get back in and work on those assignments to keep up to date.
Okay, آخر إشي فوق عنا بالخانات اللي هي all my work. مجرد ما تضغط عليها هيفتح لك هذه الصفحة. في عندك على اليسار عندك all assessment, in progress, completed, not started. All assessment كل الassessment اللي للإنجليش والمات واللانجوج اللي أخذها السنة هذه. In progress لسه بيشتغل عليها الولد وبيحل فيها. Completed كل الassessment اللي حلها وخلصها. Not started الassessment اللي ما حلها ولا فتحها ولا عمل فيها إشي واللي بيكون مكتوب عليها do مثلا Friday وما عملها لازم يرجع يحلها على أساس يضل learning path تبعه level مستوى زي ما هو ما يضل ينزل ويطلع ينزل ويطلع. Yes.
Okay. Does anyone have any questions that they would like to ask now in regards? Anyone that still hasn't been able to log on, just reach out to your homeroom teacher and they should be able to set you up. For middle school, your maths and English teacher should have you connected already. But one of the most important things is the students need to keep working on these paths because this is directly linked to the international assessment that they take. So that means that the more work they put in on this, it will improve their overall grade. So they need to make sure that they complete all the work that they have been assigned. So for example, this active assignments area here should always only have 3 assignments left in it because everything else you should be completing. It should always have your language, math, and reading, learning paths, but then the other activities will disappear once you've completed them. So that needs to make sure that you keep on top of your work and complete your assignments when they are due or when they've been assigned to you.
Okay. آخر إشي في حد أي عنده سؤال في أي حدا ما قدر يعمل login exact path, please reach out to homeroom teacher وخليه يعمل كل password الحين. الحين في شغلة مهمة على home page لازم تظل تعمل update لإلها وتشوفوا إنه الطالب حل ولا ما حل. الactivities اللي بحلها بمجرد ما يحلها ويعملها completed بتروح عن الصفحة بتضل الactivities اللي ما خلصها. لازم تأكدوا إنه تابعوا عملهم لأنه مداومتهم على exact path بيضل يحسن من مستوى درجاتهم.
Okay. Thank you all for attending. This will be posted up onto our TV channel for anyone on YouTube. So for anyone who wants to rewatch it back and go through the video. But if there are no further questions, thank you for your time and have a lovely evening. Yeah. Okay, I think that's it, Mara.
Okay.
I haven't got any questions in the chat or I don't see anyone asking any questions. So I think we're good.
في أي حد عنده أي سؤال أي استفسار عن exact path, please reach out to homeroom teacher. والفيديو هذا رح نعمله upload على اليوتيوب channel للparents بحيث لو عنده أي سؤال أي استفسار راحت عليه أي نقطة يرجع للفيديو حيكون موجود على اليوتيوب channel.
Right. Okay, thank you. And goodbye.